Alzheimer's, testing, diagnosis, treatment, and quality of life. It is a strange, sad irony that so often in the territory of a disease that robs an individual of memory, caregivers are often the forgotten. Karen Wilder. Alzheimer's in its beginning stages. If you feel a loved one may be showing signs or symptoms of Alzheimer's disease, schedule an appointment with their primary care physician. Your primary care physician will then refer you to a neuropsychologist where a battery of tests will be performed to determine a person's short-term and long-term memory, attention, concentration, reasoning, ability to solve problems, and learn new information. Test results are then compared to peers of the same age and education level to determine if a person may be impaired. Here are a list of some of the tests that neuropsychologists give for those who may be suffering from signs or symptoms of Alzheimer's disease. First, they do a physical exam and then a neurological exam. Often there are blood tests, lab tests, a mental status is checked, and then brain imaging can be done. What areas of the brain are affected by Alzheimer's disease? There are dominant genetic markers and proteins that are associated with the development of Alzheimer's disease. They are amyloid precursor protein, or APP, presenilin 1, or PS1, presenilin 2, or PS2. Most people have these markers and if they live an unhealthy lifestyle, they are more likely to develop Alzheimer's later in life. Alzheimer's disease attacks neurons in the brain that control memory, communication, and repair. Alzheimer's disease attacks the neuron connections in the brain related to memory within the entorhinal cortex, hippocampus, and cerebral cortex. The destruction of these neurons is devastating and can affect a person's ability to speak, their behaviors, and reasoning. Treatments for Alzheimer's disease. It is important to remember that in all stages of everyone's life, a healthy diet is an integral part to anyone's well-being, but it can make a world of difference for those suffering or in the development of Alzheimer's disease. It is important to eat foods high in omega-3 fatty acids, drink lots of water, exercise, and drink healthy protein shakes. Activities such as listening to music, being social, reading, gardening, all of these things help to keep a person's mind happy and active. Medications play a key role in the early stages of Alzheimer's disease. They include cholinesterase inhibitors, memantine, and it is important that these medications are started early and to realize that they do not cure Alzheimer's disease but help to aid in slowing down the onset of memory decline. Therapy is also an important part of coping with Alzheimer's disease, not only for your loved one, but also for yourself as the caregiver. It is important to talk about your feelings and your emotions so that you don't hold in the stress of being a caregiver. What to expect once your loved one is diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease? Being diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease is an emotional experience, not just for the patient, but also for the family as well. It is important to remember that this person is still your loved one, even though their memory is fading and they are not able to function as they used to. Ways to make the living process easier are to keep things like valuables, keys, wallets, and important items in the same place. Having a daily routine with medications and meals, maybe even creating a checklist for these routine items. Make sure to set up a routine with your bill paying and activating a location setting on a loved one's cellular device so that the caregiver can locate the person affected by Alzheimer's disease more easily. Make sure to remove clutter from pathways, have good non-slip shoes, and have your loved one wearing a medical alert bracelet in case of an emergency so that other people know that this person is suffering from Alzheimer's disease. What to expect as the caregiver to a loved one suffering from Alzheimer's disease. Being a caregiver to a loved one diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease is not easy. It can often be a stressful, thankless job. It is important to remember to have a good support system in place, not just for you as the caregiver, but also for the person that has been diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease. You and your loved one are going to need someone who listens, a calm, stable environment, and someone that helps wade through the grief and confusion of dealing with Alzheimer's disease. Coping with someone who has Alzheimer's disease can also be physically demanding on your body, create feelings of being alone, and can be very draining on the caregiver's health. Remember to reach out to friends and family and ask for help. Express your thoughts and feelings. Take a break from the role as caregiver occasionally and get out to socialize. Make sure to eat healthy and exercise and take times to do things that are bringing you joy in your life. Quality of life after diagnosis. This is a devastating disease that causes grief, stress, and feelings of loss of loved ones and with those diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease. Unfortunately, there is no cure for Alzheimer's disease, and those diagnosed will slowly decline. It is important to talk to others and stay informed, create a good support system, and maintain healthy habits. I want to thank you all for watching my video, and I appreciate you.